Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernard from the BTNHD, and today is all about building a Docker swarm, and let's get into it. Okay, so I'm getting myself into the Docker world, and the more I'm learning, the more I'm pushing out these videos to you guys. So I learned how to build a Docker swarm, and I'm going to show you what I've done so far within my environment. So within my environment, I created four machines. I'm using VMware Workstation 15. I have two managers and two worker bees. All four machines are running Ubuntu 20.04. All four machines, I install SSH server on it. I enable the firewall on all four machines, so I'm able to PuTTY into each machine rather than going inside the virtual machine, right? As you can see on the screen, I am inside the manager one, manager two, worker one, and worker two. Now on manager one, all four machines have Docker. So on manager one, I'm running Docker version 19.03.11. The same thing with manager two, the same thing with worker one and worker two. So all four of these machines have the same Docker version. Now the first command that we are going to do on the manager server would be the following. And just make sure that you add the parameters of advertise address and also the listen address. Now the advertise address and the listen address should be the IP address of your manager. Okay. Once you enter this particular command, you're going to hit enter. Once you hit enter, it's going to initialize the swarm and you're done. It's going to give you a command line to add a worker to the swarm, and that's what you need to enter. Now, if you're entering another manager into this swarm, you need to run this particular command. And you hit enter, and it's going to actually give you the command plus the token that you need to add to the additional manager. So what I'm going to do is copy the entire line, and I'm going to go inside manager two, and I'm going to paste it. Now, before you hit enter, we need to add the two additional parameters. We need to add the parameter of advertise address with the manager two IP address and with the parameter of listen address with the IP address of the second manager. Once you hit enter, bam, that manager server is now added to the swarm as a manager. So now I have two managers. Now we need to add the worker machines into the swarm because right now we only have two managers, right? We got manager 01 and manager 02. The primary manager right now is 01. So let's go back inside the manager console. We're going to copy that command that allows me to add a worker within the swarm. And we're going to go inside the worker 01 machine. And we're going to paste it. When you copy the command, make sure you add the parameters of advertise address with the IP address of the worker machine and also the parameter of listen address with the IP address of the worker machine. Hit enter, bam, the worker machine is added to the swarm. Then the last thing that we need to do is go inside our second worker machine, add that command line, and again, make sure you add the parameters of advertise address, change the IP address, and also the parameter of listen address with the IP address of the second machine. Once you do that, hit enter, and that machine is now added to the swarm as a worker machine. Now within the manager console, if I run the following command of sudo docker info, it gives me information of everything. And if you look close right here, the swarm is active, and I have two managers, right? And now I have four nodes. I have four nodes because manager 01, 02, worker 01, and 02 are considered nodes within the swarm infrastructure. If you also take a look here within the manager address, I have two of them. 131 is manager 01 and 132 is manager 02. Now, if I run the following command of sudo docker node ls, it gives me a list of all the machines within the swarm. And as you can see, everything is ready. Availability is all active. The manager status right now, like manager 01 is the leader and manager 02 is reachable, right? Because that is my secondary manager. And then worker 01 and 02, no status because they're just the workers within the swarm infrastructure. Let's pull an operating system within our Docker system. So I'm going to run the following command of sudo docker pull Ubuntu because that is the image that I want to pull. There's actually four layers within this image. Three of them are already completed. And the last one just got to wait until it's done. Once it's completed, you're good to go. Now I'm going to run a sudo docker images to see the image. Awesome. And then I'm going to run the following command to create a container. So we are going to do a sudo docker run with a parameter of name. We're going to give our container a name and we are going to do a parameter of IT Ubuntu. So we are going to do an interactive console to Ubuntu, which is the image. Once you hit enter, you're going to see that your command prompt is going to change. This command prompt indicates that you are now inside the container. So if I run a ls with a parameter of l, and that shows the directory of the Ubuntu container. If I do a control C to get out of it, it takes me back inside the manager console. If I do a command of sudo docker ps, it gives me a list of all the running containers, which is the container that we created. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that like button. Also, do not forget about punch, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. I'm having a lot of fun dealing with Docker. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the videos, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.